the year of our Lord, 1348, Florence is tragically oppressed by a monster plague. On a Tuesday morning, seven other women meet in the church of Santa Maria Novella. Pampinea starts to speak. Death is all around us. For this, I think it is a good idea to leave this place. Her companions agree. Meanwhile, three noblemen looking for their own wives go into church and join the party. So, the next day, the Merry Brigade arrives at a beautiful manor house in the countryside outside Florence. A king is elected each day. For 10 days, each of the 10 companions will tell a story on a theme chosen by the king. On the fourth day of stories with tragic endings are told, Fiammetta starts to tell her story. Tancredi, Prince of Salerno, would have been a man of great goodness if, in his fourth age, he had not dirtied his hands with the blood of lovers. He had only one daughter, Ghismunda, whom he loved so deeply that he could not part from her. He delayed her wedding, and, after she became a widow, he didn't want her to marry again. Ghismunda was tormented by isolation, but she did not dare ask her father for another wedding. So she decided to find a secret lover. She left Guiscardo, a handsome man with a noble soul, but of humble origins. Ghismunda often saw glances at Guiscardo and fell in love with him more and more. Guiscardo fully returned her love, so that Ghismunda was his only thought. Ghismunda devised a plan to meet Guiscardo. She wrote a letter, hid it in a bamboo cane, and gave it to Guiscardo. After finding the letter, Guiscardo managed to meet his beloved according to her instructions. The chamber of the young lady was connected by secret stairs forgotten by all to a cave. This cave was hidden among bushes and shrubs and excavated on a mountain adjoining Tancredi's palace. Guiscardo climbed down into the cave with a rope and waited there for Ghismunda. There, the two embraced. And then they went to Ghismunda's chamber, where they spent most of the day together. After their secret meeting, Guiscardo went back to the cave and waited there until dusk, then left unnoticed. While Ghismunda joined her mates, the two lovers met secretly again and again, until fate, envious of their happiness, transformed the joy into pain. One day, Tancredi went to Ghismunda's chamber, but did not find her there, so he fell asleep on a stool at the foot of the bed, hidden behind the canopy. When he woke up, he saw his daughter lying in bed with her lover. Tancredi decided not to reveal himself and, when the two lovers parted, he climbed down into the garden, making sure no one saw him. Prince Tancredi sent for Guiscardo, who was captured while he was sleeping in the cave. Guiscardo was brought before Tancredi. The prince scolded the page for this offense. At these words, the young man answered that love is stronger than anything else. Love can much more than I or thou can. So Tancredi ordered that Guiscardo was imprisoned. Then Tancredi scolded his daughter for such a gross and outrageous affair with a lower class man and informed her that he had imprisoned her lover. Ghismunda stood up herself, openly declaring her love. She first blamed her father for his jealousy. Then she blamed destiny for giving Guiscardo such humble origins. Finally, Ghismunda proudly said that she would kill herself if her lover died. Tancredi thought that his daughter would never be able to commit suicide. So he ordered his men to strangle Guiscardo, to rip his heart from his body, place it in a golden cup, and send it to Ghismunda. Your father sends you this to comfort you toward what you love most. After much crying and kissing the heart of her beloved, Ghismunda poured poisoned water into the cup and drank it. Then she lay on her bed waiting for death, with the heart of her beloved next to hers. Wounded by her mates, Tancredi ran crying to her daughter's deathbed. Ghismunda did not want her father's tears, but asked him to be buried together with her beloved.